Parasites are pretty much always bad news, right? The word parasite says sci-fi horror, not real life. And you're right, they're generally not great news. A parasite is any organism that lives on, or even in, another organism, benefiting at its expense. For example, there's a parasitic louse that can chop off the tongue of a fish. The louse sets up home as a replacement tongue and feasts on the blood and mucus of the fish. Yikes. But did you know, in the bacterial world, a parasitic enemy can actually turn into an ally under certain conditions? Let me explain. Hosts and their parasites are constantly evolving across generations. They're in this kind of evolutionary arms race. The parasite attacks, the host evolves a better defense. The parasite evolves to overcome those defenses, and they become more destructive in the process. The host evolves to change its defense tactics once again, and this can continue in endless cycles over successive generations. But what if an even more harmful attacker comes along? A bacterial pathogen, say. Well, in this case, the original parasite can actually evolve to protect the host against this new threat. And here the relationship will change from being parasitic to being mutually beneficial. After all, the parasite is dependent on the host it calls home. Therefore, in some cases, it can make sense to protect it. The original resident parasite might protect the host via a number of different strategies. When the host is under attack, the parasite might start to produce larger quantities of a toxin that can damage the invading pathogen. Another way the parasite can protect the host is by thieving. You see, just like humans, bacteria need to feed on iron for proper growth. Bacteria produce compounds that allow them to catch iron from the environment. But the original parasite can steal these iron-catching compounds and make the invading pathogen go hungry. Another way is that the parasite might increase its numbers in the host. This increase in army size can make for better protection against invading pathogens. As well as being super interesting, this research could help us design better medicines in the future. Classical medicines, such as antibiotics, are static. They can't change in response to an evolving pathogen. This means pathogens frequently evolve drug resistance within an individual patient. However, if we were to fight microbes with microbes, we might have a treatment that's able to constantly evolve in response to an evolving infection. This is some way off, but it's an exciting prospect. So now you know, to turn an enemy into an ally, you might just need to invite a worse enemy to the party. Though I wouldn't advise this outside of the microbial world. Thanks for listening.